Now that we have grouped the minterms into the proper groups, next we want to combine these minterms to become implicants of 2 minterms. How? We are going to combine them from the neighboring groups, for example, group 0 with group 1, to see if any of these minterms are differing from each other with only one variable. For example, minterm 0 over here and minterm 1 differs only in variable D. So these 2 minterms can be combined. So what we do, we give tick to these 2 minterms. Then after that, we take a note that we combine the minterm 0 and 1, and we give this notation for the 2-minterm implicant. We put a dash where the variable change value. This means variable D disappear in the implicant. Let us see one more example. Now what we want to do is comparing minterm 0 from group 0 with minterm 2 from group 1. So you can see from here, there is only one variable change also, which is this one, variable C. So we will tick minterm 0 again, and since it is already being ticked, we don't have to tick anymore. But we will add one tick to minterm 2. And then we list out one more implicant, which is the combination of minterm 0 and minterm 2. And we put a dash where the variable change, in this case 0 to 1. And this also indicates that that variable, which is in this case is variable C, will disappear in the implicant. The next combination is obviously we are going to combine or compare minterm 0 with minterm 8. Obviously, there is also exactly one variable change, which is in this case variable A. So we will take minterm 8 and combine the two to become a 2-minterm implicant that loses variable A, because variable A changed from 0 to 1. So we complete or we finish comparing group 0 and group 1. Next, obviously, we have to compare all possible pairing of group 1 and group 2. So if you still couldn't see the pattern in the way we compare the minterms, let us go through one more example. First, we need to compare minterm 1 with minterm 5. How many changes are there? Obviously, there's only one change in variable B in this case. The rest, variable A stay 0 to 0, variable C 0 to 0, variable D 1 to 1. So minterm 1 and 5 can be combined, and we will need to put a tick next to minterm 5. And also, let me highlight again, we combine minterm 1 and minterm 5, and the variable that is dropped in this case is variable B. So as you can see here, it is 0-01. This is the notation for this implicant. So far we combine all minterm that we compare, but now we have to compare minterm 1 and minterm 6. How many changes are there? Variable D change from 1 to 0. Variable C also changed from 0 to 1. Variable B also changed from 0 to 1. Only variable A stay. So in this case, minterm 1 as compared to minterm 6, there are 3 changes. In this case, we cannot combine these 2 minterm. Minterm that we can combine can only be differing in only one variable. One and only one variable. So
we are not going to put a tick in minterm 6, and we are not going to list it here. So after that comparison between minterm 1 and 6, we will skip forward, and we expect you to be able to do the rest on your own, because we don't want this video to be a very long video containing only comparing and ticking and listing of the combined minterms. But we will show you when we start comparing minterm 5 and minterm 7 in group 3. But we will give you the correct tickings and the correct listing of the combined minterm in this slide, so that you can check your work whether or not it is correct. Okay, at this point, we finished comparing group 1 and group 2. Next is, of course, to move on to comparing group 2 and group 3. So let me show again how the comparison is done and see if minterm 5 and minterm 7 can be combined. Variable A, 0 to 0, it stays. Variable B, 1 to 1, it stays. Variable C change from 0 to 1. Variable D, 1 to 1. So these two minterm of 5 and 7 can be combined. We will put a tick at minterm 7 and we will combine or list it in this listing for next stage of combining. But before we proceed, you can see that over here, when we combine group 0 and group 1, we have implicants of no ones. This will be group 0 in next comparing and combining. And this will be group 1 because there are only one here in every implicant that we listed in this group. So obviously, you can guess that by combining group 2 and group 3, we will have group 2 over here where the implicants are having 2 ones. And since every minterm are having tick, meaning there is no minterm that cannot be combined, and we are not going to keep any of the minterm here to become essential prime implicant. So this one is group 2. This group 2 is the resulting implicants by combining group 2 of minterm and group 3 of minterms.